We find ourselves at the home of the world's first retractable natural grass field as you get a look inside State Farm Stadium in Glendale. Here's the former Sooner Austin Seibert to get this one started. And off we go on EA Sports. And he won't quite make it to the 25. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. First play from scrimmage. Here's Murray. And oh, right away, he lost the football.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. Now Murray. And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete.
And this drive is almost over before it began, thanks to a great defensive effort. Sack on first down, followed by an incompletion. One more good rep, and they get off the field.
And I don't think this is the script they had in mind for their opening drive. This is third and long. From the gun, Murray. And this will be swung out here for counter. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. Call it a pickup of three, and also now likely a punt on their opening drive.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And it will be Washington football now with a first and 10. The Washington offense set to take over. On first down, here's Daniels to throw. Got a man. It's the rookie out of the third round. Yeah, they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
Sometimes we overrate the ability to see things differently if you play quarterback. But this young man did, and he uses it to his full advantage. Inside-outside versatility and works well in traffic.
A first down throw for Daniels. He's going deep for Brown. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Second and 10. From the shotgun, it's Daniels. That's complete to Austin Ekeler, the running back. 5 yards, now it's third and five.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way. And really, we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Here is third and five. They go play action. Daniels. Steps away to his left. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
As we both know, there was a lot that went into why they made him their first-round pick this year, and part of it was what they saw in college, his playmaking ability when things break down. As soon as he saw he wasn't getting a lane to throw, he pivoted and found an alternate way to the marker.
They'll run for the first time with Austin Ekeler. And a good burst there right from the start as he'll get this one out near the 35. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two. You often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
First carry of the game for Brian Robinson.
And he'll be taken down at the 34. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
Working out of the gun, Daniels. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals' 24-yard line. Give them 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward.
Solid opening drive so far, Charles. They've moved this football into field goal range, but you know that they want to cap this off with six and not three.
Absolutely. As one of the better coaches in the league always tells me, on offense, I want their body blows all game long and finish it with uppercuts. Well, here are the body blows right now. He's hoping one uppercut will take care of the end of this drive.
We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
And McLaurin going to pick up a Commander's first down as he's down to the 11. Give the rookie another one on this opening drive and a first down with it. A nice start, Charles, for the first-year passer. He's come out, made a few plays, nice plays to begin this contest.
He certainly has. If he finishes off this drive with a touchdown pass.
Touchdown, Washington. Terry McLaurin, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Commanders will jump on top with the game's first score here this afternoon.
An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt, and then you go down and score.
And you've got to see a fist pump on the sideline from the head coach, don't you? Because he's turning to his bench, and he's telling his team, this is how we prepare. Force the punt, go downfield and score. I told you guys, it's just like a boxer in the gym preparing for the fight. Now we get to turn it all loose.
Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. So the Cardinals offense back onto the field here for their second drive of the game.
These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
He'll get eight on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
And that's an early scramble that can be viewed positively by either side. From the offensive point of view, it begins to establish him as a possibility to keep it on certain plays. And defensively, they avoided giving up a huge play in one of their first tests in containing a quarterback on the run.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Back in Arizona, second quarter action. It's the Cardinals in possession as they've got it with a first and 10. Right back to Cotter here on first. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. So they'll get the yardage on the run and get 15 more for good measure.
Yeah, that wasn't too difficult to spot. You heard the sideline erupting and the flags came out almost immediately.
So now factoring in the face mask, here's first and 10.
To throw is Murray. That's complete to Michael Wilson. And he'll be pulled down as a penalty flag will rein in as well, and that would appear to be a face mask. So give him the yardage on the completion and also tack on 15 more.
If you get that hand up there, you've got to let go immediately or just not close the hand at all. He didn't, gave it a tug, and that was easy for the officials to see.
After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10. Murray a give. This is Connor. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. How about Jonathan Allen there, pushing upfield to make the stop behind the line?
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
After the loss, they'll come up second and 13. Running right on the option is Murray. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. Just a loss of a yard there, but it's not going to help. Now they face a third and 14.
Boy, the pursuit there, terrific from the linebacking core.
Oh, it certainly was, because so many times on an option play, you'll see a linebacker make a beeline for the quarterback and then zip, one cut, and he's grasping at air. But this time, he locked in on him the whole way, took an excellent angle, and his grasp came up with the quarterback.
A throw left sideline falls incomplete.
Smart move to throw that one away. You're in field goal range, so you definitely don't want to be loose with the ball. And that's great work by this defense to force a fourth down.
Fourth down, Murray off, and the Cards field goal unit and Matt Prater out there now.
This just a 35-yard attempt from the left hash. Prater's kick is good, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3.
So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one-possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
Prater now will send it away following the made field goal. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. Now Washington going to retake the field for drive number two. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated. They both game planned for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first. We often give credit to the O-line there, two tight end formation. Those tight ends block pretty well also.
Yeah, and that's one of the most dynamic positions in football now. The tight ends who can block at the line of scrimmage at the point of attack, and they can also get downfield and catch the football.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
And he'll get it down to the 47 here. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Any team that runs the toss and runs it successfully, that means they win the battle on the edges. That means you seal the edge in order to let your back get to the corner. They got it done there for a very nice game.
So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 47. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Zaven Collins, the outside linebacker, dropping him for a loss of six.
Pressure can come from all over when you're plotting a defensive strategy. On that particular play, it just came from the outside.
Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. To throw is Daniels. Got a man, it's Diaby Brown, complete. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals 37. A new set of downs after a strong pickup of 16 yards.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Daniels now to throw on first down. This will be caught once again by Brown. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. 12 more yards for him there. It's a first down.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Now this one to his running back out of the backfield. Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
Washington now going to use the first of their 3 timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime.
Let's go now. 19, Tiger, 19, Tiger.
Off the play fake, Daniels. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. Another shot from the 9 on second and goal. Now Daniels. He's got it. Touchdown, Commanders. Diaby Brown. A 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Commanders will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. There was a lot. And we remember, of course, all scoring plays need to be verified upstairs. And I think they're going to at least take a look at this. Seibert on for the PAT. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. Well, the Cardinal offense going to take over late in this first half.
And with him down two scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range. Murray now on first down. That one almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there, and it'll be second down.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line. Here's Murray. A short one here, caught by McBride. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Now a third and 6. Out of the gun, here's Murray. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. First and 10 here, and you know, if they could just get three out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost. Murray's throw complete to McBride. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and that'll bring up second down.
And there wasn't much room for the big tight end to do much after the catch. But at least he was able to pick up a solid gain to help his offense continue to move in the right direction.
Now second and 3. Again, they'll throw with Murray. He'll get this to Connor underneath. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. So we have reached halftime here in an 11-point contest. As we send you on out to our studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. So Washington in a good spot. They've got the lead. They will get the football as the second half gets underway. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
They'll come up now second and 4 from the 31. Throwing now is Daniels. Looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. And McLaurin going to pick up a Commander's first down as the tackle going to be made up at the 37. It'll be a gain of 6 that time as it moves the chains as well.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Here's Daniels. This is Ertz on the pitch and catch. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Ball spotted at the 45. Here's second and 2. In motion left comes Brown. Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. Oh, what a juke into space. And he will take this all the way down to the Cardinals' 16-yard line. A big pickup of 38.
How about that there? No frills, no additives, right? Nothing crazy. Just find a way to pick up the first down. A nice run right there.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Robinson up the middle. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. On the tackle, it was the West Virginia man, Kaiser White.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Here's second and seven. On the draw, Robinson. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. Tried to go draw play out of the gun down here.
Yeah, they tried to spread things out, didn't they? They wanted to move people away from the center of the field, away from the line of scrimmage near the ball, so that the runner could find some space. Unsuccessfully, though.
To the air goes Daniels. On the screen, this is Eckler. And he's going to be taken down, but there's a penalty flag in the backfield. Is this a hold, or did they rough the quarterback? So a critical mistake, roughing the passer. Now it's first and goal. Daniels looking to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
I certainly like what he did right there because he smartly wanted to avoid forcing anything downfield because nothing appeared to be open. Nice harmless slide there to avoid the big hit, and he gets a small gain on the play.
Robinson will score. Touchdown, Commanders.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical, that's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock too with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now. Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. The Cardinals offense now ready to get their first opportunity here in the second half. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 23. He'll start the drive with a give to Connor. And they're able to get this one across the 35. First down yardage on the first play of the drive, give him 14.
Connor picks up a new set of downs and in nice fashion, too. He's coming off his best season as a pro after he topped the 1,000-yard mark for the first time in his career a season ago.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Again, a run with Connor. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one?
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end.
From the 44-yard line, here's second down and 3. Murray giving to Connor on the option, and he'll get it down to the 47 here. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Here's Connor on the read option. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Dante Fowler in on the stop.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And now Murray's going to set up the throw. He'll get that one complete to Connor. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Murray going to try to throw on third down. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
Throwing on first down is Murray. And down inside the 15 he goes. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first.
Has not been a big game for him throwing the football. I think he feels like, let's try something different. Let's use the legs here and see if we can make some plays.
And no passing touchdowns, yardage not where he would like it. Try something new. It worked there.
From the red zone, here's the Heisman Trophy winner, Murray. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a halt. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's second down.
Well, it certainly appears to me that the defensive guys are starting to look a little bit tired while he still has some fresh legs. Not the biggest gain we've seen on a scramble, but still some positive yardage on a play that initially looked like a sure win for the defense.
On second down, here's Murray. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. Jonathan Allen. He's the culprit, dropping him for a 2-yard loss.
Well, we've seen how this quarterback can beat you with his legs. Saw it earlier on this drive, as a matter of fact. But that time, they had him covered.
They really gave him no place to escape because oftentimes they're able to find a crack, a sliver, anything that can get them upfield. On that occasion, nothing open.
And he's going to go down again. Dorrance Armstrong, he's the one to get him this time, and back-to-back sacks brings up fourth down.
Well, he was really focused downfield, but there was really no viable options. The coverage was too good.
And the defense really quickened the tempo of that play with their pass rush because there was nowhere for him to go with the football. The only place he ended up, down on the ground.
Now Murray's got to have this one, and he's going to look that one in one-handed. What a catch for the touchdown.
Well, they needed 3 scores to have any chance. There's the first of the 3 as they get into the end zone.
Yeah, Brandon, I think that our guys at Next Gen Stats in charge of the win probability are probably saying your chances still aren't great. But now, you still got more than 3 minutes to go. You got to focus on the task at hand, which is going to be getting the football back as quickly as possible.
Extra point good by Prater, and it makes the score 21-10.
Two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back.
And this is going to be covered up by Washington.
And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that, just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics would tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers, aren't
you? All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
They don't lie.
And good work there in open space. And he's got this all the way down now to the 32.
12 yards is the pickup, and it's good for a Washington first down.
And what a tough spot for this defense, because they know it's coming, but they're just powerless to stop it. What a great run there to start the drive. And you can bet there'll be more where that came from as they try to ice this game away.
On first and 10, it's Robinson. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine.
Another run on second down, trying to cover up. And a hard-working run here as he's got it inside the 20, down to the 17. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
They'll run again here with Robinson. And he'll take this one down near the 15. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. This, in all probability, another run here on second and 8.
Straight ahead, it's Robinson.
And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. The Cardinals forced to burn their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Third and 3. Robinson will try to pick it up. 67 yards rushing for him now as he's carried it 13 times.
Starting to look like this drive, it may be the final nail in the coffin.
Well, this is why you work out so hard, right? This is why you spend all that time in the offseason. This is why you have those OTAs and mini camps for these situations, these scenarios, to run someone into the ground and secure a victory.
Washington about to close this one out as they are down to a knee.
Here we go. 50 Bison, 50 Bison.
Down to a knee one more time, and that should just about do it.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right? Just us against the world and get it done. How happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something. And they did in this one.
So it's Washington getting the victory here.
And you look back over the score sheet, interesting. A very clean game, no turnovers by either side.
an absolute rarity when we watch games now because defenses have put such an emphasis on taking the ball away. Well, what we saw here was offenses spending their time saying, look, you know they're coming for it. Ball security is paramount. So they worked on that, not just a week of practice, but I'm sure all during training camp. Make sure when you have it, tuck it away because danger lurks everywhere you turn.